Hi guys, I'm Claire, host of this YouTube series and author of the website brilliantbotany.com. Today I'm going to be talking about some really cool research into mosses, fertilization, and volatile compounds. You're probably familiar with plant-pollinator relationships. Pollinators, like bees, butterflies, bats, or even lemurs, visit the flowers on angiosperms, flowering plants, and transfer pollen between them. This allows that pollen to fertilize egg cells and further reproduction. Flowers often offer incentives, like nectar, for pollinators, and have evolved things like bright colors to attract their attention. Hummingbirds, for example, are drawn to bright red flowers, like torch lilies, and bees follow ultraviolet nectar guides when visiting flowers. Mosses, however, are not angiosperms, so they don't have flowers, and if you'd like a quick intro into the moss life cycle, you can check out this video that I made a few weeks ago. It has long been assumed that mosses are fertilized only with the help of water. When it rains, the moss sperm cells swim through the water using their two flagellum to get to egg cells and fertilize them. Recent research has shown, however, that springtails and mites aid in fertilization of mosses, much like angiosperm pollinators. A study by Todd Rosenstiel and his team, published in Nature, has even shown that mosses produce volatile compounds to attract microarthropods like springtails. The study looked at the moss Ceradon purpureus and springtails, tiny arthropods that live in leaf litter. Researchers found that the moss produced sex-specific volatile scents, meaning the male moss and the female moss produce different compounds. In part of the experiment, they gave springtails the choice between male moss and female moss and found that springtails much preferred the compounds given off by female moss. And finally, researchers compared fertilization rates in samples grown with and without water spray to simulate rain, or with and without springtails. Both water and springtails separately increased fertilization rates, though springtails more so. Having both water spray and springtails made the fertilization rates skyrocket. What this means is that having both rain and microarthropods like springtails is the optimum condition for fertilization in mosses. This makes sense since mosses grow in the leaf litter where microarthropods live, and also in damp environments. This is exciting because we already have research that shows that some angiosperms give off scents to attract pollinators, but research into this type of relationship in mosses is new. It's amazing that something as small as springtails, which are only a few millimeters long, and mosses can have this complex of a relationship. If you have any questions about mosses, plants, or pollinators, please let me know. This has been Brilliant Botany episode 10. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.